everyone, hope you are good and be happy always. Once again, welcome to Shachi's Academy, and today we will discuss the uses of could. Could is the past tense of can and used for past possibility, past ability or for formal request. So let's start with that. We use could when we talk about past possibility or ability. If we say that Tom could swim, okay, so we are saying that in the past, before 2 months, 1 year, 3 years, or for about past years, he could swim. Or if we say that my mother could speak 5 languages, so we are saying that she could speak those languages in the past also. Okay, so here we can see here the structure of could. How do we use could? Subject plus auxiliary verb plus main verb. This is the same structure as we have discussed in the use of can. So here subject may be any name, that is noun, or we can say pronoun, anything, etc. Like just like Ram, Sita, Tom, or Walter, John, etc. Then auxiliary verb. Here we have used the auxiliary verb could. Could is the auxiliary verb. You can say model or a helping verb that helps the main verb. Then comes the main verb. Just we can say that John could write in English, or John could write French. John could speak French. So this is the structure of basic structure of sentence. Now, examples. My uncle could drive. That means in the past, my uncle could drive a car or a scooter or anything like that. Then Tom could not swim. That means they are saying that he did not have ability to swim at that time in the past. He did not have that ability. Now, could Tom swim? We are asking a question. Could Tom swim in the past or not? So we are testing the ability or the possibility over here. So for these type of sentences, could is always used. Then some more examples can be here. Just like Aryan could swim when he was 5 years old. That means when he was just a kid, when he was only 5 years old, he could swim then also. Okay, so that is the past possibility or ability we are expressing. My mother could speak 4 languages. Just now I told you, this is again the past possibility or ability, that is my mother could speak 4 languages. Any 4 languages she could speak when I was young or anything like that. You could add on. Okay, my mother could speak 4 languages when I was very young. Even and now she can speak 7 languages. You can elaborate this sentence in this manner. Then could you understand her speech? That means the speech has been finished just now in immediate past. And you are saying that could you understand? Or could you decipher anything? Could you get anything from that speech? What she was saying? That means you were unable to understand, and you are asking someone that could you even understand her speech, what she was babbling or saying anything. Okay, then when I woke up, I could not move my leg. In certain discussions, when we say that when I slept, I was okay, but when I woke up, I could not move my head, I could not open my eyes, I could not feel my hand, I could not feel my legs. Somehow you go into these type of discussions, and then you can make use of could also. That means past possibility you are saying, okay, not move. That means that day, some day you were not able to move your leg. Now, when we talk about positive sentences, okay, in our general sense it is okay, we can use could. But when any specific instance is there, when any special occasion is there, we do not use could for positive sentences. We use be able to for positive sentences. We can see the example. That means specific occasions, these all are general occasions. That means generally she could speak, generally he could swim, generally you do not understand anything like that. But for any specific day, what happened on that day, for any specific incident, we need to use able to. Here we can see a dog fell into the pond. That was some specific day, because dog normally doesn't, daily he will not fall into the pond. But on that day, when he fell into the pond, a dog fell into the pond, the boatmen were able to save him. Why we have used able to? Because that was a specific occasion. Because on that particular day, a dog fell into the pond. So that was a day when boatmen were able to save him. Now, if for the same sentence, you are framing a negative sentence, right? We can say, this sentence will remain the same. A dog fell into the pond. This will remain same. Now, the boatmen were able to, this is positive. But if we frame the negative sentence out of this, we could say, boatmen couldn't save him. We will use, instead of were able to, we will use could not or couldn't save him. So for negative sentences in past occasions, specific occasions we use could not for negative, but able to for positive sentences. Understood? Then move on for the request. Now we can use could for requests also for formal request in present tense. Okay. So could you tell me where the post office is? So this is your formal sentence. You are meeting some stranger or some official or someone whom you are asking that could you please tell me where the post office is? Please, this is a formal request. Formally you are asking, that means official purposes or any formal settings you can say. Could you send me the PDF, please? You are requesting someone formally, informal settings or informally also. But the thing is, you are making a polite request over here. So, could you send me the PDF, please? So, in official purposes, you can say, could you send me the PDF, please? Could you send me the email? Could you send me the catalog? Could you send me the book? Anything like that. Then, could you give me a glass of water? This is again a request to someone, like if you have gone to some restaurant, if you are going to some hotel or anywhere in the party, so you are asking a waiter or waitress or anyone stranger also, you are saying, could you give me a glass of water? If you are not able to take that water, you can ask someone, but make a polite request. For these type of polite requests, code is used. So hopefully this is understood by all of you, and you can take the screenshot and just practice these sentences and frame your own sentences. Just speak in front of your mirror, speak in front of your phones. Nowadays phones are there, you can practice sentences and you can see how do you speak those sentences, how you pronounce those sentences, and just jot down certain sentences which you do not understand and frame your own sentences. Keep on practicing your sentences, and this manner you will be able to speak fluent English. Thank you so much. Take care. God bless you.